The thing is, each chunk size, it will assign it to a thread.
Yeah.
It's so static. Okay. But in dynamic, what happens is, like certain amount of chunk size will be assigned to each thread.
Yes.
And if some more chunk is left remaining,
mm-hmm.
then the one which finishes first, the thread which finishes the execution of that certain chunk first will get the remaining.
Yeah. Right.
But in static, it uses round robin. That's what I guess. Yeah. I think.
In static, it uses round robin. That is what he's mentioned here. Okay. See, schedule static. Now four threads, assuming four threads. So this is assumed to first thread, then goes to the round robin to the next thread, then third thread, then fourth thread.
Yes, sir.
Okay, this is for one chunk. If you don't mention any chunk numbers, this is one chunk. Now, if you mention chunk size as four here, what happens is, see, again, this entire thing is divided into four chunks.
Yes.
Okay. That means four stars each.
Yes.
So four stars. After execution of four stars, it preempts. Then it gives to the next thread. Then preempts. Then gives to the next thread. Only chunk is like time slot.
Okay.
You can understand it as a time slot of the processor, what this thread gets.
Okay.
Okay. So that is what static and chunk sizes mean.
Okay.
You got it, right? Yeah, let's fall back to the program. That is what this does. There are chunk sizes. Yeah, here. Schedule static chunk. So now chunk we have given here as 10. Okay, 10 is the chunk size in our program. So now talking about 10, where is our slide? Yeah. So talking about 10, now this entire thread time is divided into 10 chunks.
Yes.
In this case, it was 4.
Mm.
Here, it was 4.
Mm.
So, this way, you will have 10 lines.
Yes, sir. Section.
So, yes. this entire piece of each thread will be divided into 10 chunks. And then it starts executing.
Yes, sir.
Okay, that means each thread, little by little, it starts executing. That's what we have mentioned here. Eight threads and then 10 chunks. See, this is actually a little bit advanced program than what you require. You don't have chunk requirement here. In this particular program, if you see, there are no any chunk mentions. Your teacher didn't ask about chunks. But this program, what we are seeing, also has chunks. It also satisfies that. Okay, so in that case, you will get full marks.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So, this is one thing you need to remember. See, there are three lines here to remember. First, chunk and threads you have to mention.
Okay.
Then this you have to make it to zero, the dynamic environment of OMP.
Okay.
Then you need to span parallel regions.
That's a command, right? Yeah.
This is a command. And this is the command.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Hash pragma open parallel shared private and num threads. Three things you need to remember.
Okay,
then this line. This is again default line. OMP get thread number. This dynamically gets the thread number to assign. Which thread to assign?
And put it in TID. Yeah. Thread number means what it will assign, sir. OMP get thread number will be number of threads assigned, no? To a certain chunk.
Yeah. See, I'll show you the output of this. You will understand. Okay, let me come out of this program. I'll show you the output. You will understand. Hold on. See, what I've done, the output I've captured into this text file. Okay. See, I've run the program. This dot O I have created. And then I've captured it into this. So when I run, when I open that, see, now these are the thread IDs. Thread ID 3, 2, 5.
Yes, okay.
Then it says, starting matrix multiple example with 8 threads. Okay. Now, see, initializing matrices. Matrix initialization is done. After that, See, thread ID 7, which thread should execute now? See, out of all these threads, which thread must get the time?
Mm.
Who decides that? There are 8 threads.
Okay.
See, you are a manager.
The chunk eight... size, sir. Static chunk size. Round robin.
It actually doesn't work as round robin, as shown in the picture. But some thread will get the time. Some thread will get the time. See, here in this case, first thread ID 7 executed. Okay, thread 4, starting matrix multiply, then thread 3. Okay, then thread 3 finished it, then thread 4 did, then thread 6, starting matrix multiply, like that. Then thread 1, then thread 5, thread 7, thread 2. See, it's not round robin, actually. In the real time, it's not round robin.
Okay.
I mean, it is round robin, but not in a very, very fine sequence. It's not circular. Some thread will get tasked to execute. Like that, it executes all this. Okay, see, this is the matrix actually. 500 by 500 matrix it printed. Okay. Then finally, I've added this line to give the time for you. Till here, it is done. And this line... to calculate the time, I have added in the program.
Yes.
This is the time taken for doing the 500 by 500 matrix with 8 threads.
Yes.
Okay. This one. 500 by 500 for 500 input size and 8 threads. So here you have 0.8.
Okay.
That time you have to put here. Okay. Yeah. So let me go back to the program. Yeah. See, this is what all the initialization of matrices it is done. Then it said thread starting matrix multiply. This is where from it is printing. See, now TID. Now TID is randomly coming from this command.
Yes.
Okay, that is what this does. This randomly gives you thread ID.
Okay.
Okay. Then start your time. And this is where you multiply. This block is to multiply, that's all. This much block. This for loop is to multiply.
Yes, sir.
And then finish your time.
Huh.
So finally print the result of the matrix. And then print the time.
Okay.
Understood. Time taken for the entire thing.
Yeah.
Okay. Now.
It is easy program, 78 lines.
Yeah, nothing is there. See, simply initialization of matrices itself has taken some 20 lines.
20 lines, huh?
Around 20 lines. So what you need to remember is just see.
Yeah. 50, 40 lines.
Nothing.
Yes, sir.
See, all this is nothing. See, it started from 10.
Yes.
Not from 1. So, 10, first 10 lines are gone. This you don't require.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, this is all initialization of what all require. Okay. Then, this particular thing, only 3 lines you have to remember, Jiraj.
Yes, sir.
Only 3 lines you have to remember from here. This line is important.
Yeah.
Then this block.
No.
Okay. Then you initialize all the arrays. Then start the timer to calculate the time, final time. And you start the same thing.
Execute.
Same thing whatever you have done here. It's the same line.
Okay.
That means 4 times you are using the same line. Once here, second time here, third here, and fourth here. Then you start the for loop, then you multiply the matrices. See, A, I of K multiplied by B, K of J. That you are storing in C, I of J, that's all. A element multiplied by B element, you are storing it in C element.
C element, yes, sir.
That's all you are doing. C is a temporary array. Okay. Now, stop the time, end the time, then print the time.
Yeah.
See, now this for 500, if you do, okay, that is what you have got, what I have done, what I have shown.
Yes,
now
sir,
I change the, we'll yes, change sir, the values and then see.
Okay.
So, what is the other value you require? 250.
Yeah.
Okay. 250 and 4 we will see.
Okay.
250 and 4 we will see. So, for 250 and 4, if you want to execute, what you have to do? You have to come to hash define of array size. Okay. I will make it 250.
Okay.
Okay, 250 I have made. Now come to number of threads line. Make it 4. You have to get the size from here. 250 and 4. See, yes. Your master may ask to change this also. Or else this is written by you only.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
So you have to decide how much values you want,
mm-hmm.
and then put them here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then save the program.
Mm.
Then come to the command prompt.
Mm.
What you do, you run the GCC command.
Yeah.
GCC matmul OMP, matrix multiplication OMP.c. This is the name I have given. Okay. Now, where should my output go into? See, this specifies matmul OMP program with 250 rows and columns, 250 RC. 250 RC is 250 rows and columns with 4 threads. That is how I mentioned this name, that's all. See, 250 rows and columns, and 4 threads. See, same thing if I execute 250 rows and columns with one thread I save in this file name, in this executable.
Okay.
Two threads I'll save like this.
Okay.
Four threads. And then 8 threads. So, all are different executables. Four different object files you will get. Okay, that way you can save them. So now it is 4 threads, so I'm putting 4 threads.
Okay.
250 rows and columns, 4 threads. So I'll just execute this. Now, ls matmul star or matmul star. See, program is same.
Okay.
I've changed the values inside. First time when we saw, I had 500 rows and columns with 8 threads.
Okay.
Now I've changed it to 250 rows and columns with 4 threads.
4 threads. Okay. Okay.
Now this is what we have created, this object.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Got it right?
Yeah.
So now I'll just execute this. Okay. See, now I'm redirecting this to a file. Or else, their output will be scrambled like this on the screen.
Some input or output or txt or some txt file.
Yes, some txt file I'll give. So what txt I'll give, it'll be the same name again. Okay.
Yeah. Have you made it?
No, I'm making it now.
Okay.
I'm making it. Once I run it, it'll be made.
In the same directory,
in the same directory. See, this is what is the earlier text file which I opened here.
Oh, okay.
This one with 8 threads and 500 rows and columns.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So it got made here. Now this one will be made. Let me execute this. Enter. See, now it is made. LS matmul star. Where is that? This one. You see it?
Yes, sir.
250 RC 40.
Yeah.
So now if I open this with gedit, with editor. Where is my gedit? Yes. See, this is matmul with 80. 500C, 80. This is matmul, 250RC, 40.
Where, sir?
Here, here. At the last tab. Your screen is not refreshed?
It's refreshed, refreshed.
Yeah. So this last
tab. I'm not getting to know where. Last tab.
Yeah. You see this? Okay. The black one popped up.
Yeah, yeah.
That name. Just above that, see the name. 250RC40.txt.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. See, out of two tabs, this tab I'm talking about. This tab is open. Now here, if you see, four threads are created. TID equals to 1. TID equals to 2. TID equals to 3.
Yeah.
And then 0. Yeah. So 0, 1, 2, 3. Four threads are created. Now it is starting matrix multiple example with four threads.
Okay.
Then it is initializing the matrices. That matrix initialization block. Then this is how all the threads start executing. See, this random number of threads is coming from that command.
Okay, sir.
You remember which command? This command.
TID, yes.
TID. OMP get thread number.
Yes, sir.
This is the fellow which is supplying this random dynamic numbers for threads. Which thread should execute kind of thing. So eventually if you see, it is done. See, I am pretty sure that your teacher will not see all this. Your lab in charge or whatever. They will not see all this. Okay, whether they are multiplied or not, they may not check. They will only see the times. Okay, see now for 250 input, with just four threads, it took this much time.
Yeah.
Okay. This is how you have to execute, Shirat.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So you just need to change these two values. Hey, what is this? Hold on. This is a different window. This is a different. This we don't need. This was yesterday's. Okay. Because I never shut down my PC, right? So, all the things will be there. It's been years that I shut down my laptop.
What, sir?
It's been years I didn't shut down my laptop.
Okay.
So, yeah, this is the program. So you know where to change
you
the
just
value,
put it to
right?
sleep
as soon as I close my lid it goes to sleep.
Okay.
Yeah, it's been like 5 years running the same way. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So these are the lines where you need to change the number of rows and columns. And threads you need to change. Only these two lines, if you change and run multiple times, you create .o files like this. LS matmul. See, like this. Your program, single program is one. Changing the values and keep creating .o files like this.
Okay.
See, 500 RC 80. Before your lab in charge comes to check the program output.
Okay.
You create all these files. 16 files you create with different outputs.
Okay.
Which are mentioned. Like,
okay.
See, with input 5, 5RC, 1T, 5RC, 2T, 5RC, 40.0, 5RC, 80.0.
Okay.
You got it, right?
Yeah.
Like that for 250RC, for 250RC, 1T.0, 250RC 2T.0, 250RC 40.0, 250RC 80.0. So four files are done here.
Okay.
Similarly for 500RT, 500RC, 500RC 1T.0.
1T, mean only one thread.
One thread. 500RC 1T.0.
Okay.
Next one is 500RC, 2T.O, 500RC, 4T.O, 500RC, 8T.O. So 16 files you should have, 16.O files you should have in your folder.
Yes, sir.
All that 16 values, you have to keep changing the values in this main file, program file, and then generate them and put them readily. When your master comes and asks you, show me the input for, what is it, 100, 100, 100 input size with 2 threads, then you can immediately run that particular program.
Yes, sir.
That single object file you can run and then show.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes.
Then that will become very easy for you.
Okay.
So, you understood, Chirag? All the things?
Yes. It is more than the program, the execution only is complicated.
Yeah, execution is only complicated. But execution also, it's just routine task.
Yes.
It's not complicated. It's just routine task. Only thing is that you need to keep on changing the values here and then execute and save this file.
Yes, sir. Huh.
Like that. So this folder I'll send you.
Okay,
hold on. Let me send you now itself, or else I'll forget. Where's my email? Yeah, here. So I'll send you on top of this itself. I don't know to which mail ID is this. This is RVC.
Correct.
Where is your kid?
Behind shield.
So when will he come out of shield? Okay, where is my DC? Here is my DC. Now, 7. You know about this DC? This is
no,
a very
sir.
Very one beautiful tool.
Okay.
This is your Explorer.
Okay.
Okay. So you can have split screen like this, left and right. And on left side, and left side I'll have all the Windows tabs, Windows folder tabs. And on the right side I'll have Ubuntu Linux folder tabs.
Okay.
If I want to copy from Linux to Windows folders, I just simply drag. Now you see what I'm doing here on the right side and the left side is Windows. Now whatever program now whatever program we have done here is in Ubuntu.
Yes, sir.
So Ubuntu file, how do I attach to Gmail? Not possible.
Okay.
Okay. So what I do, I just in Windows, I just create a file called Matmul.
Ubuntu file you can't send, sir, in Gmail.
No, how do you send? First you need to pull it to...
Normally you open Gmail and you compress and then you put it now.
Yeah, that see, if it is in your home folder in Ubuntu, how do you take it to Gmail?
It just compress, sir. It'll just ask, select which file you want to attach and you just attach.
Okay, you do it that way. Fine. No issues, sir. No issue. So I'm sending you these files, 80, then matmulomp.c. Okay. So forget of your program.
Okay.
Just look at only this program, matmul.c, matmulomp.c.
Matmulomp.c, the last one. Okay.
The last one.
Extension C. Okay.
So I'll just pack it here. Okay. And where is my pack file? Yeah, this I'm sending it to you. Sorry. Over here. I'm just dropping it. So this contains the source file and then create two created object files along with output files.
Yes, sir.
Okay, how do you run that? You want me to copy these commands as well here?
Yeah, sir. Just copy paste it up.
Okay, where is GCC? From this line, I'll put and show you one thing. Okay. this thing. One run is there in this.
Mm.
How it runs.
Mm.
Commands. Okay. So like this you execute.
Okay.
Nothing to worry. Okay. So all these 16 Dato files you create and put it. Mm. Then whatever he comes and asks, you just immediately, or else you can simply redirect like this. See, mm. after creating Dato file,
mm.
you can redirect it into a text file, the output.
Okay.
Output you can redirect into 16 text files separately, all with different names like 250 RC 40.
Okay.
So as soon as he asks you to show the output of this thing, you can simply show this. And at the end, you will have times, right? This is the file which is open. So at the yes. end, you will have the time taken for execution.
Okay.
That you show and then close it.
Okay.
Okay. So this I'm yes. sending. Okay.
Yes.
So once if you practice, you will understand. Nothing complicated in that.
Yes, sir.
At the first glance, it looks complicated, but actually it is not.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So that's it, Nashira. So
yes.
next class, any program, what do you want?
I'll let you know, sir.
Yeah, you please let me know one day before.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. Let me look into that and we'll see.
Mm.
That TOC thing, something you sent me, right, sometime back?
I sent you the TOC thing, sir, but I don't know the portions properly. I'll let you know.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay then. Yeah.
Maybe the TOC, I'll just, I'll